NASA's Artemis mission, as we said, will help return man to the moon and beyond.
News 19's Emily Mosner has some more details on that important test happening this week that will help determine the launch date.
We have the Space Launch System, the Orion capsule, and we are ready to roll to the pad.
It's a big week for NASA and the Space Launch System, which NASA will use to send astronauts to the moon and beyond. On Thursday, teams at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida will roll out the rocket to the launch pad, where they will conduct what's known as a wet dress.
We do literally a countdown, where we go and make sure that the systems are talking, that the whole vehicle, the Orion capsule and the Space Launch System, are talking not only to each other, but that they're talking to the launch pad, and so that when we are ready to push the button and go, it will be going.
While the test and later launch will happen in Florida, it wouldn't be possible without the work done here in Alabama. Monday, the director of the Marshall Space Flight Center spoke with the Rotary Club of Decatur about the city's contributions to one part of the SLS, the Orion spacecraft.
One of our companies in Decatur is ULA. And ULA is responsible for what we call the interim cryogenic propulsion stage. And so that's what gets us the extra kick up into space.
Marshall Space Flight Center Director Jody Singer says while space exploration is a worldwide effort, it's great to see North Alabama making such large strides in the process.
Knowing that Huntsville and Rocket City and River City is all a part of it, you know, from liftoff to landing to returning safely to Earth, this area is critical in the part of it and making it happen.
Reporting in Decatur, Emily Mosner, News 19.
And of course, News 19 will continue to follow the latest from the Kennedy Space Center and bring you updates on the progress of the Artemis program on air and on WHNT.com.